Hi everyone, this is Brad. Today we're going to take a look at Cami from a teacher point of view and student point of view. Now I've Googled Cami Chrome extension and this is what comes up. You have to scroll down if you'd like. You could watch a video here and you see the overview about it being a great PDF and document annotation and markup tool. So let's go ahead and add the extension. This is the first time that you're adding the extension and you have not logged in before. You'll need to go up and go through the whole sign-in process. What I'm going to do here is I'm just going to select here. And when I do that, you can see I'm already logged in. If you're not, you have to go through the sign-in, typically Google, and then choose that you are an educator. Now, over in here, you can see your different options. You could create a classroom assignment directly from here. So you really don't have to go directly into Classroom. You could create a classroom assignment from here. We're not going to do that right now, but if you're interested, you can do that. If you have questions, you need some help, they have a great help center. So if you just select it, it's also help.camiapp.com. And then you can type in some questions that you have, or if you like more information about using Cami in your classroom, you could see them right in there. So again, that's help.camiapp.com. Okay, you can also see your other options in here as well. Here's your menu, as well as if you'd like to sign out or go into dark mode or go into your settings, so on and so forth. Okay, but what we're going to do, we're going to go into our Google Classroom and we're going to start from there. So let's go ahead and let's start fresh. So here we are in Classwork. What we want to do is we want to create a Cami assignment. If you don't see this Cami assignment come up right away, it's because the Chrome extension has not been, either you haven't added it or you're not officially logged on. A few things to point out. If you click right up in here, what class is it for? If you want more than one class, you could certainly do that. So you can see that one's checked and so is the other one. If you just want one, you can just do one, as well as your students. And do you want it published or do you want it as a draft? Over in the right hand side, feature restrictions. Do you want to restrict some things? And you'll see them in just a little bit. It's possible you may want to take off the ability to comment with a video. You just may want them to text or audio. Again, 100% up to you. You can see your other options as well. You know, I don't know why you need a signature, but you know, whatever it may be, whatever you'd like to use. I'm going to leave them all on for right now. And that is the default that they're all on. In this example, we're just going to call this an example. And you could give, you know, instructions or whatever you'd like. Now, down in here, your points, the default's always 100. If you don't want it, you can just leave it as ungraded. Or if you just click in here, you could just say 50 or 20 or whatever it may be. I'm going to leave it at 100 for right now. The due date, let's go ahead. Let's make this due Friday. Now you're going to see the time come up. So if you want, I'm just going to select 2300, but then it's going to say, oh, okay, let's make it due at 11:55. Over here, schedule time, do you want to schedule it now? Or do you want to schedule it starting tomorrow or whenever? Topic, again, it's according to your Google Classroom, you know, what would you like it to be in? Now, over in here, something to point out, you could grab something directly from Google Drive. So what I'm going to do here is, let's say I start a new document. Again, you can always go into doc.new to start a new document. And let's just call this Cami, and I'll just call this Cami sample. Okay, so if I want to use this as a PDF, let's just say I have something in here and I want them to fill it out, whatever it may be. What I can do is I can grab directly from Drive and then I could search right in here. Let's search Cami and then I can choose right in here. I can select it and then here's what's going to come up. It's going to say, hey, what do you want to do? Do you want to make a copy? Do you want to share one copy? Or that they can't edit the file? Typically, you're going to want them to make a copy, so that's the default. So again, just wanted to show that right in there, that is how you can grab directly from your Google Drive. In this example, though, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab from my desktop. I'm just going to grab a PDF that I downloaded, a math PDF for like first grade. So let's go ahead down in here. And math worksheet, select open. Okay, so all I did is I went in and just found one online, downloaded it to my computer. It was a PDF, and here it is. Now, something that you want to take a look at, send Cami instructions, and we'll see this in just a little bit. So when we do that, I'll show you what it, you know, what it kind of looks like here. And we're going to just select assign. Again, everything's all set, makes a copy for each student. We're doing it now. Let's go ahead in and assign it. Now, when it assigns, give it a little bit of time. for it to go ahead through. So here you can see the assignment's been created. However, what we've done, which is nice, is we've sent this link to students, especially the first time they're doing this. Here's what comes up. So let's go ahead and click here. This Google Doc, and you can see right in here, some tools may not be available because there's a lot of people on this, especially right now. I do have the document, so you can see how it says click file and make a copy. If you would like this, I do have it here, so I could certainly share this with you. It is up. It's up to you if you'd like it or not. But again, it's here. And if you really want to make this your own, you can always, even though it says you can't go to file, make a copy, you could just remove after preview and just type in copy, and now you can make a copy. So you may have to give it a little bit of time for it to officially come through, but you can see it's going through and it will then create a copy in your drive. So just give that a little bit of time if it doesn't come up right away. So here it is, you can see it. So if you need this, let me know. I can certainly send it on to you. So here you go. It takes the students through the whole step of what they'll need to do. So it's nice, it's available for them. You don't have to give them a step-by-step tutorial. It's already been created. All right, so it's been created, it's ready, we can see it's here. So let's go in from a student point of view. What would they see and what would they do? So let's go ahead in. So here we are. We're gonna need, as you can see, I'm just gonna say got it for here. Here it is. So I'm gonna view the assignment. Let's got it again. And you can see there's nothing come up. The reason it's not coming up is because we don't have Cami yet. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in Cami extension. Again, this is from the student point of view. Let's go ahead, add to Chrome, and add extension. Here it is populated right up in here. I can click right up in here. I'll need to log in with Google. Choose a name. Make sure to allow. That may come up one or two times, especially early on, just to let you know, K-12 school, at least that's what I've found recently. And then their role, their student, and then they select finish. And then it gives them a little welcome too. So we're just gonna select continue. And then we're gonna close out of it here, because what you'll see now, if we go back to Classroom, let's go ahead back, let's go to Classwork. You can see it right in here. They can always select view assignment if they would like to, so you can see the whole thing. But here's a PDF right over in here. So if we select this, since it's their work, you can see it comes up as a PDF. And what we can do is we can open Annotate with Cami. Many times you'll see the Cami over in here. So let's just take a quick look, just so you can see that. Many times, not always, but many times it will come up. So let's view details. Let's go back one. Let's just go right from here. Okay, it didn't show up yet, but a lot of times it'll say open with Cami right up in here. If it doesn't, you can just say annotate with Cami. And then on the left-hand side, you'll see your annotation tools. They're also gonna see that they are a student as well. Now you see all these options are available. Again, what I talked about before was possibly removing the comment feature for being able to do a video comment or a screen capture. Again, entirely up to you. But what you can see over here, you can always hide this as well. So here we are. So the basics behind this. If we go to a text box, I can change the font size. Let's make it 24. And I can click right up in here. So I can instantly and easily annotate this document. If I want to, because I've already typed this in, I could go in and change the font size as well, but I'd have to highlight the text. Even you can see other options up here as well. I'm not gonna go through that. All right, so if I need to circle ways to make five, a couple ways to do that. I can come down in here. I can see there's a drawing. If I want my color to be red, I can certainly choose red. I can change the thickness of the line, and I can say, well, 3 plus 2, 1 plus 4, all right. If a mistake is made, you can see it's been saved. I can always undo it, take those away. If I'd rather go into a shape, you can see all the different shapes that are available, as well as more colors. So if I want to remove, I don't particularly care for that color, let's say, I want to add this one. I just hit save, and now that is available right here. can also go head in and do an ellipse. So it's a little bit easier and looks a little bit nicer. So over in here, just to show you a few things, you can do a dictionary. So if there's something that comes up, highlight. Oh, I don't know why it's coming up looking like that. Let's go through and do this. Okay, there we go. So I guess within there, for certain ones didn't come up. I've never seen that before. But here we have definition again. Whoops, right up in here. If we just highlight math, there's your definition there. So I want to show that to you. Text to speech. You can go ahead in, get started. It's going to read any text that's on there.
Name. Week of September 7th. Math worksheets. Com. Asterisk HWD Ilyan.
Okay, so it's going to take you through. Of course, you can go in and change the voice, but it's a nice feature to have. You can even change the speed if necessary. Markup, you could go through, you could highlight certain things. So in this case, we're just doing a regular little highlighter. You could do a box highlighter, and let's change it to red so you could highlight this in here. You could go in, and of course, here's the comment. I'll show you that right here, because what the comment can do is this, is if we had a question about this one, the student would select comment and then not sure. They could always select over in here and do a little voice typing as well. Again, entirely up to them, but if they do that, just know that it's going to start voice typing right away. Not sure what to do here. Whoops. Not sure what to do with this one. Okay, and then you'd have to go ahead in and select the mic as well. All right, so you can see that. Now, if they want to remove their comment, they can certainly do that and just get rid of it. If they would rather go in and leave a voice comment, which sometimes is a little easier, I'm not sure exactly what to do with this problem here. Hit stop, goes through. And again, you can see this here, like I stated before, that sometimes that's going to come through where the student may need to do that, especially the first time. I've noticed that a couple times as those go through. Not a big deal, but just something to point out. All right, so you can see.
I'm not sure exactly.
Okay. Over in here, if you want, it's a video comment, so they could create a video, a screen capture. Over here, text box, you can see all your different options. Equation. So you can go ahead through. Let's just do greater than. So let's select that. And then if we go in here, obviously what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to make this a little bit larger. So if we create it, here it is. But if we want, we just have to click, put it in, and there's your greater than. Of course, you can always undo and get rid of it. But there are other symbols, you know, obviously as well that you would can search through. You can see music. All right, your drawing tools right in here. Change your color, shapes, eraser. So an eraser, in this case, you can see, get rid of all annotations. You can just click on that. Or let's just say we drew something, you know, whatever. I can go ahead through, go to my eraser, and I can just, whoops, let's undo that. You can just erase here as well. So just something to show you. Let's see something. I thought if I go to the eraser, it says all annotations. All right. Yeah, it's going to erase all of that. So anyway, just wanted to show that to you. Insert images. You can go directly from your drive. You can open from your computer. You could do a Google search. You can also go ahead in and add some stickers. Signature. You can upload an image, draw an image, and so on, or add a new signature. And then over in here you have your descriptions if you want to remove that. Now we've gone in, let's pretend as a student I've finished all this and I'm ready to turn this in. If you look right up in here, turn in, something to look for is always the unsaved changes, which may happen, like right here, especially early on, it will have that. So what I recommend doing is just telling them to save now. That being said, it will also save as they hit the turn in. But it's kind of nice that this is what I would do, is I would just hit that save. But you'll see saving to Google Drive. So it's saving to Google Drive again, just to let you know that happens. And then once it's turned in, you can see they could unsubmit if they'd like. But what we're going to do here is we're going to go in and you're going to go back. And you can see that if we go under Classwork, View Work, it has been turned in. And again, View Details. Here it is, it's been added. Again, just as a reminder, private comments go directly to you, class comments go to everyone, and you can see it's worth 100 points. So now, as a teacher, I'll show you what it looks like. All right, so I'm gonna go in, come back to classwork, I'm gonna see example, I wanna view the assignment, and I can see one's been turned in. So if I wanna see this, who turned it in? Ah, this one did. So if I click right here, I can then select it here, and I'm going to grade with Cami. Now it's up to you, you do not have to, but you can see your options over here where you can type in how many points they had. Again, entirely up to you. Private comments built into Google Classroom here as well, so it will go to the particular student. Now, something to point out. You notice that there's a circle here, so that means that there's a comment. What I recommend doing is this here, hide this side panel, because now you can see that a message was left. So if I'd like, I could listen to it.
I'm not sure exactly what to do with this problem.
Okay, so what I can do is I can click right here and I could leave a comment as well. So if I did that, hey, just wanted to let you know, all you need to do is take a look at it. G-I-H-J, what's going on here? What do you think it is? If you have questions, just let me know. Thanks. Bye. Good job on your other work. Okay, whatever it may be. So you can go ahead through it. If you don't like what you just said and you're like, it's not the way I want to say it, you can do that. Then, of course, you could add your own comment. You cannot remove a student's comment here, just to let you know. Of course, you could add your own information in here. You could go through and just say, you know, good job, whatever it may be. And you can see changes are being saved. So you can go ahead through. If you would like, again, if you want that side panel back, again, you can just bring this here. You can also notice that things are here as well. There's a comment bank if you'd like. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to bring this side panel back. You can see here it is, when it was turned in, so on and so forth. Private comments, I can say good work. And it's built directly there. I can post. Let's pretend, you know, pretend it was 100 points. I'm going to post it. Make sure, if you want to, you can return it, but you don't have to return it, because why return it if it's already finished? If you want to return it and hand it back to them, you certainly could. Over here, you can return the submission, return multiple submissions, it's up to you. You know, should you want to return it, certainly could. I'll show you what it looks like before we return it. So if we go back in, you know, a student can go ahead in, and obviously here it is. They want to view the assignment, they can see that they had their private comment from you. Again, we didn't return this, but if we now go in and show you what it looks like, if you do return it, return. Okay, so it will be notified and can check any grade you left. So if you want them to know the grade, you want to return it. So let's return it. Now let's go ahead back in. Again, this is the student point of view. View assignment. Okay, so they can, their work, they can select it. Annotate with Cami. They can see any comments that you've made. Okay, so you can go ahead through. Okay, so here they are in here. You can see over here, this is the student. This is taking off me if I left anything in, but you can see it removes annotations from the teacher or the student. You can see that I wrote in there, good job. If we bring this back, you can see all that the student has done. Now, for them to see the grades, what they can do is go ahead back in, and let's select classwork, and let's go in just to show this to you right in here. If we select view assignment, there's an easier way to do this, but I wanted to show this to you. You can see 100 out of 100 here. You could also go ahead in here, and if we go back one, what we can see is view work. You can see 100 out of 100 right here. You can also see in here anything that's assigned, returned. So again, this has been returned in here. One more thing to point out, select the hamburger, to do, and then you can see things that are assigned, things that are missing, things that are already done. And you can see your grades right there. So that's Cami. Should you have any questions, please reach out. Thanks for watching. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.